Kings of the aisle. I could have made a somersault out of it, but you don't show pain in public. After the initial shock, it felt as if the whole left side of my abdomen was being pinched by an industrial strength metal clothespin that had been heated up and stuck where a drill bit is supposed to go, and then running reverse, drawing me up tighter and tighter until it stripped around triple knotted, burning nerve tissue in my gut, and I couldn't move. After 2 or 3 paralyzing minutes, which felt like 20, Craig rushed me to the hospital in my car. I never let Craig drive, and if I did, I would never let him drive fast. But that night was his lucky night, because I made damn sure that he did both. I was in pain, real pain, so much pain that I swelled up with mad bouts of rage. I cussed, snarled, and spit at everything in our path, even the red traffic lights he didn't stop for. But for some strange reason, though, I never said fuck you to the pain. I walked into the emergency room entrance, hunched over fast. I threw my wallet at the lady behind the desk and hit her in the chest, and I screamed at her as I kept walking past. Here's all my information! My appendicitis just ruptured on the wrong side of my body, and I'm going to die! Then, I went unescorted straight to the back, found the first table, and laid down on it. The world's fattest worm squirming in compost poison hell, coiling in upon myself with suffering. The staff cried after me, "Sir, sir, sir!" Echoing louder and louder, the exact opposite of an out-of-body experience, everything going in to one loci twisting axis evil Monday. They found a bed for me right away, but as quickly as the pain came, it disappeared. And it disappeared about the same time the doctor got there. Hold on. I sometimes have trouble with this part. This experience also marks the first time my rectum was violated. There, I said it! A short, thin doctor of Indian descent came in, put on one latex glove, told me to pull down my underpants, lay on my side, bring my knees up to my chest, and expect some pressure. He gave these instructions with quickness and authority. I trusted him. I'd heard of this exam before, but always as the subject matter of jokes and at the expense of senior citizens. I never believed it could happen to me. I was 16, a child, for God's sakes, laying there anxious, prone, and exposed, and no longer in pain. I looked over my shoulder and let out a soulful groan. The doctor had stuck one blood finger, probably four, into a jar of transparent grease, and then all of that went into my ass, and it gets worse. When he moved around it in and out, it really, really hurt. And the whole time I'm thinking in slow motion, I don't want this. I don't need this. It doesn't hurt anymore. It went away. I'm okay. Then I pulled up my underpants like a robot, got dressed, and walked away. What happened to me? What just happened here? I got no answers, I got no medicine. Did they think I wanted drugs? Did they think I was lying? Do people make this type of thing up? What just happened to me? What did I do? Is it my fault? What did I do wrong? And it was like that for days. Now pain has a way of making you make sense of it. And that's exactly what I did. Hello, my name is Brian Lewis Saunders. I'm 16 and I'm allergic to popcorn. Trust me, it was years before I ate popcorn again. Time after time, people would offer me popcorn, and instead of seeing a harmless, white, light, fluffy, flowery food, I saw it for what it really was, a vile seed, treacherous burger bees, prophecy in a pan. About 2 months passed, and the pain returned several times in a row. Not nearly as strong, though, so I wrote them out alone, dismissing them as mere psychophysical aftershocks. Then, a year later, I was laying in bed, deep asleep,
in the basement when... Wake up, motherfucker.
It's way up again! I tried for hours to pick myself up off the floor. I couldn't move. And not only did the pain have 100% of my full and undivided attention, but that wicked pain got me fetal hostage and then started in with the interrogations, bright white light and all. Who are you? What were you doing? What did you just do? I was sleeping. Why were you sleeping? What were you dreaming? What did you eat? Nothing. You ate popcorn again, didn't you? No. You want to go to the hospital again, don't you? No. Get visited again. No, don't you? What's wrong with you? Can't you take it? What were you thinking? You did this to yourself because it happened in your sleep. Popcorn, cracker, jackass, fist-ass, butter-lover, stupid faggot. What's the matter? Can't you get up? What's wrong with you? Can't you take it? No. What if this is cancer? What if this never stops? I know. And this went on for 3 sleepless days and nights straight. And if that wasn't bad enough, I couldn't keep any food down, not even Jell-O. So on the 4th day, I went back to the hospital. I went back to the hospital, I had to, and they ran $4,267 worth of tests. I gave them blood work, I gave them urine samples and stool samples. They checked my reflexes, they looked at my mouth for diphtheria, and then they ordered a lower GI and a cystoscopy. Then, poof, the pain vanished again, gone, like nothing, like I had never even experienced it. But I still had to get the lower GI and cystoscopy because this was very serious. I lost more sleep, anxious. I had great anxiety about the pain and great anxiety about the test. In preparation of the lower GI, I had to drink a whole gallon of lemon-flavored chemicals, or at least enough until my shit was clear, and I couldn't keep that down either. Then, they pumped radioactive fluid up my rectum while I lay naked spread out over an inflatable children's swimming pool. And during the cystoscopy, my consciousness was severely impaired, in and out of it to say the least. I remember at one point lifting my head up in a brilliant white room with brilliant white beings, with brilliant white clothes, all of whom were intensely preoccupied with me down there in my privates doing a cystoscopy. But other than pissing razor blades for 24 hours straight, nothing was even wrong with me. The doctors all said so, the doctors all agreed, it was all in my mind. I told the cab driver on the way home, I get it, that's where all these alien abduction stories are coming from. 123 Medical Lane, 123 Medical Lane. In your rectum, with anxiety, driven sleep deprivation, hallucinations, walking in a video camera, scraped up and down your pistol and missed it for nothing. The word I rate does not even come close to accurately describing my anger and hostility towards the medical profession. But what could I do? Suicide was not an option. So I slept. Mysterious. emotionally. Fear and anger are brother and sister. Stay with me here. My anticipation of more pain equals fear. And my perception of doctors as ignorant equals anger. And when both of these feelings taboo fornicated inside my head, I became the proud father of a bouncing new baby, bad blood, emotional incest, offspring of hatred towards man like none I'd ever known before. I have this little pet. His name is Daku. All of his teeth and claws came in. I no longer eat. I only feed him. He can't be killed unless I die. He is an invisible part of me. Daku is bad mystery. No one, not even doctors with all of their machines, can see him. Machines may make him high, but medicine makes him angry. And we don't want him angry. He digs and claws, needs and tears, rips and gnaws, and chews tunnels in my gut. Always moving forwards. Sometimes I feel like rescuing him by taking a knife and freeing him. Cut Daku out! Sometimes I think he's cancer. Daku says yes, but the doctors say no. I get a pain in my chest when he's not in his nest. I can't walk when he's hungry. I can't sleep when he's lonely. I often try to talk to the Daku, but he doesn't listen very well either. He's unruly, and I think Daku is deaf. If I stabbed him, I'd be certain of relief. Daku hates to be petted, so I poke at him. He's outgrowing his tank. Daku can also eat in two different places at the same time. He's right here, just begging me to stab him, gut myself, pull him out and stomp on the Daku. Daku's no friend. Daku is killing me. All of my silverware is plastic. I need something pointy, strong, and sharp, but the Daku can outrun it. Daku is fast. I know his every move. If I was brave, I would starve him. Starve me. But for now, I'm going to get him some sandwiches. What should I do? I can't go to the doctors. Which is worse, a doctor or Daku? A doctor is one highly skilled in the arts of healing. I looked it up, but by purposely not helping or healing, he is hurting, a.k.a. co-torturers, a.k.a. Daku. So I go to work. Wham! I'm in the car. Wham! I'm walking down the street. Wham! I come home, sit on my bed, cross my legs, test my reflexes, look in my mouth for diphtheria. Oh, no diphtheria. No swollen glands either. Then I shit on my floor, cut it in half, smear it, no blood. Then take a few deep breaths and jam my fingers up my ass. Because we don't need another doctor. We can run our own tests. But I still need to get them those sandwiches. I'm hurting real bad. Death, chicken, chocolate. I gotta kill somebody. I gotta kill myself. What I need to do is not make Daku mad. Beat him, join him, or both. Buy a book on surgery and do it. Make Daku visible. It can't be that hard. If I can poke him, I can point to him. Just take the left half of my body, the part that really hurts. Find the middle of any cut there. I just got whammed again. No man is an island. Shit! I'm all alone right now. 85% of my body is water, and 85% of that is stagnant, and 14% is Daku, and the rest is Daku swamp, mosquito fleas, Daku malaria, tetanus, Daku lockjaw rabies. I'm a saliva Daku carrier. There's no good here. Only sickness, still pain, hatred, and the Daku. Man and beast together is one. My Siamese twin and Siamese, a rodent, a vermin. I hate myself as I hate the Daku. I also hate you. I hate you because I'm alone. You don't feel what I feel. You don't see what I see. And I see you for what you really are. A disease of evolution. The Katsu of the animal kingdom. What makes you king? You are the Daku. You are the enemy. Misery loves company. And so does Daku, pain, brutality, torture, and hostage situations. Are you following me? This is the brother and sister sex part. The part where you get whammed. Emotional incest, pain, bread, home invasion, you copy? You go to work, wham! You're in your car, wham! You're walking down the street, wham! Bob Marley said, a hungry person is an angry person, but a person in pain is on a rampage. You don't show pain in public, so what happens? It comes out sideways, like when I'm getting Daku no sandwiches. Don't you know Daku is violence? When the shit goes down, it's only me, you, and then Daku. There'll be no boo-boo kissing mommy, only voodoo rich victims of Daku. And if you're lucky, the Daku doctors after the fact. Sticks and stones both break bones, but Daku's a bit more malicious. Daku's the only true empirical magic. Daku is trauma. Daku is goddamn.